Talking there about Peter Dutton gaslighting, but I've got to say, if you are gay or trans or any of the letters of the alphabet that are reflected, you're pretty sick of getting gaslit by this Prime Minister. He said this week that he honestly thought this bill would unite people and would unite the Parliament. I mean, give me a break. We remember how Scott Morrison voted on same-sex marriage. We remember your position on it. We remember that this religious discrimination bill came out as a response to equal marriage rights in Australia. That's the origins of this. And standing in Parliament and saying that you reckon this was going to unite people, then you weren't listening. Because trans people, the gay community, were telling everyone that would listen for the duration of this argument that this was harmful, that this would damage people, that this would add to the difficulties faced by young trans teenagers who have some of the worst suicide rates in our community. It's unthinkable that we would do this to young people. And the Prime Minister stands up in Parliament and says, I honestly thought this would unite people. Give me a break. Stop the gaslighting. Be honest about what you're doing. And I think, you know, whatever the politics of it, those parliamentarians that stood up and against their own party and stood up for fairness and recognising young people and protecting their rights, I think they ought to be praised, whatever the politics of it is, because they did something very important. And, you know, I had the opportunity to talk to young trans people this week about their fears. And, you know, Dave Sharma, Katie Allen, Fiona Martin, Bridget Archer, I think I'm forgetting someone, Trent Zimmerman, you know, they all did something for those young people. And whatever difficulty they face in the party room or from their colleagues, you know, calling them liars on national radio this morning, you know, all of those politicians will go to bed tonight knowing that they've made life at school a bit easier for trans kids.
And hopefully those kids have realised that they are being heard and how they live their lives is their business, and politicians don't have any right to have a say in it at all.